All right. In that meeting as well, there were a lot of other things that you tackled. First of all, the EDSA bus carousel lane and the increase of fines. Tell us more about that, Mayor.
Correct. Again, allow me to read the resolution. MMD placed on, yes, number 23-002, further increasing the prescribed fines for the violation of the exclusive city bus lane / bus carousel lane regulation along EDSA. So we have now increased the fines, Carmina. Mm-hmm. The first offense is now 5,000 pesos. The second offense is 10,000 pesos plus 1 month suspension of driver's license and required to go to a road safety seminar. And the third offense is 20,000 pesos plus 1 year suspension of driver's license. And the fourth offense is 30,000 pesos plus the recommendation for the LTO for the revocation of the driver's license. So why are we increasing the penalties? Because we are seeing a lot of violators in the EDSA bus carousel. Remember, only marked government vehicles are allowed, emergency vehicles, police vehicles, ambulances. These are the vehicles allowed in the bus carousel. Private vehicles are not allowed, and yes, we are still seeing a lot of them entering the bus carousel. That's why the Metro Manila Council decided to increase the penalties to further deter private vehicles and non-authorized vehicles from entering the EDSA bus carousel.
Mm-hmm. And you also passed a resolution regarding the diggings that are happening all around the metro. Some of them really a hazard to the riding public, Mayor.
Yes, that's correct. Now, we have amended the fines for diggings. Light violation be 20,000 pesos. Less grave violations will be 30,000 pesos, and grave violations will be 50,000 pesos. So both the government and private contractors who are tasked to construct or fix roads must ensure that after the construction or repair, they must cover these diggings immediately, or else they will be fined. Because commonly, what causes traffic also are holes or ongoing construction that are not covered up. And thus, people have to avoid these in the roads.
Mm-hmm. All right. Finally, while we have you, let's talk about the BSK elections coming up in a couple of days. How prepared is the city of San Juan for this? And how important, really, will these elections be for the city of San Juan?
Well, number one, here in the city of San Juan, I will be here the whole time during the barangay and SK elections. I will monitor. In fact, we have been going around the different barangays, and we are seeing compliance in terms of candidates, the way they campaign, the campaign materials. So far, we have not received any violations or any reports of violations. And we will also ensure, of course, that the eve of the elections and election day, everything will go smoothly, and that everyone will follow the rules and regulations of COMELEC. Mm-hmm. How important are the elections? Of course, they're very important because the barangays are our most basic political unit. And as mayor, it is important for us to have barangay officials whom we can rely on. They should be able to implement the projects and programs of the local government at the barangay level, because they are directly in contact with our constituents. So it is really important that we elect people who we can trust, and those who will really perform properly their duties and responsibilities.
All right, we're going to have to leave it at that. Francis Zamora there, Mayor of San Juan City, also the President of the Metro Manila Council. Thanks again for taking time to talk to us today, Mayor.
Thank you very much, Carmina.